When it comes to riding a moped or motorcycle in a group, there will sometimes be a verbal communication problem. But that doesn't have to be this way, because most helmets come with indentations on the inside, where you can mount speakers, and thus use modern communication systems, like this Cardo Scalar Rider Freecom system, which offers tons of awesome features. What is not awesome though is its high price, which got me thinking whether it is possible to use the Arduino development board to create a walkie-talkie, which is basically a two-way radio transceiver, meaning it can receive and transmit audio. So in this video, let me show you my more or less difficult journey of creating such a device, but let me already warn you that it does not come with decent audio quality. Nevertheless though, let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC Pcb, where you can get $2 PCBs super easily. Also, all customer feedback is getting discussed and evaluated within the company to constantly improve the PCB ordering process, which you can experience yourself by uploading your Gerber files today. To start off, I had to think about how a walkie-talkie functional principle would work with the Atmega 328P microcontroller. Its most important peripheral features for this job are its 16-bit timer and its 10-bit ADC. But of course, we firstly need an audio signal that we want to transmit. For that, I got myself those flexible microphones, which come with a 3.5mm stereo jack and are built around a simple condenser microphone. That means all I had to do was to add a 10 kilo ohm resistor, 10 microfarad capacitor and a voltage source to the stereo jack, like it is shown here, in order to get an AC voltage audio signal right after the capacitor. This audio signal needs to get sampled by the ADC or analog to digital converter of the microcontroller in order to turn the analog voltages of the signal into digital values that we can later send. This also requires the 16-bit timer though, in order to trigger one ADC conversion, for example every 62.5 microseconds, which would equal a sampling rate of 16 kHz. This sampling rate does of course not offer the best audio quality, but let's play it safe for this first experiment, and let's rather focus on a bigger problem, the small peak-to-peak voltages of only around 100 mV of our audio signal. Due to them, the sampled digital values would only differ slightly, which could lead to distortion problems later on. So I grabbed myself the LM358 operational amplifier, which works with a minimum voltage of 3 volts, which will be important later on, and created a simple inverting amplifier with it on a breadboard with a gain of 100. After hooking up the microphone and the supply voltage, we can see that we now got a sufficient voltage range that we can work with. So now that our microcontroller got our audio signal digitalized, we need a way to wirelessly send it over to another microcontroller. For that, I wanted to use the NRF24L01 Plus 2.4 GHz transceiver, because I not only used them successfully before, but also because I had those long-range antenna ones laying around for quite a while. So after one NRF24 transmitted the audio data and another one received it, the second receiving microcontroller will once again use its timer 1 with its output pins 9 and 10 to create a PWM signal with a changing duty cycle according to the received audio signal. This way, the quickly changing PWM signal does not only look fascinating, but does also, by hooking up a speaker to it, reconstruct our previously recorded audio. And that is how a basic Arduino walkie-talkie could function. All that was left to do was to write the fitting code for it. Luckily though, before I started losing my mind creating such a complicated code, I found the RF24 audio library, which apparently offers real-time audio streaming and comes with pretty awesome features. After downloading it and having a look at its codes, I realized that it more or less follows the functional steps of an Arduino walkie-talkie I mentioned earlier. So I opened its minimal sketch in order to determine the most important pins for the components, except for the volume control pins, which I pretty much scrapped by simply setting the volume to the maximum, and then created a suitable schematic for my first breadboard test. It is important to note though, that the NRF24 requires a powerful 3.3 volt power source, which is why for my later Pcb prototype, I made my life easier by simply powering all the components with 3.3 volts. But nevertheless, after I built up one transmitter and one receiver on a breadboard, uploading these slightly modified codes and powering everything, it seemed like the transmitted audio data was properly received, indicated by the receive status LED connected to pin 6. But on the other hand, the audio quality was quite terrible. Listen for yourself. At this point, I thought the breadboard construction was the culprit for this bad quality, and thus decided to move on with a Pcb prototype. For that, I firstly decided on the size of the Pcb, and where to position the jack plugs for the microphone and the headphones, since the speaker was too quiet for my taste, the locking push button to start the transmission, the micro USB input for power, a power switch, and finally a small 100 kilo ohm potentiometer to set the gain of the microphone amplifier. I did this because at this point I was still convinced that I would mount this system along with a small power bank to my helmet and actually use it. So as soon as the blueprint of my Pcb design was complete, I created a proper fully fledged schematic for my walkie-talkie, which through the help of EasyEDA, I then converted into a Pcb design. It took me roughly around 4 hours to position all the components as close to one another as possible, while still being able to do all the routing successfully, on the top and bottom sides. And as soon as I was happy with my design, I ordered 5 PCBs of it through JLC PCB for only $2. After waiting for a week, I received the PCBs, which, like always, made a positive first impression. And once I sourced all of the required components, I firstly soldered all SMD components to 2 PCBs, and then moved on by soldering in all the THT components, which all in all took me around 3 hours. Now to program the microcontrollers, I used an Arduino Uno as a programmer, which I hooked up to the PCBs according to this wiring scheme. In the Arduino IDE, I then simply had to choose the correct microcontroller boards and the Arduino as ISP and click Upload using Programmer. As you can see, the uploading worked out smoothly, and thus I repeated this process for the other PCB and then hooked up all the external components and finally power. Just like before, both PCBs can talk with one another, but the audio quality was so bad that it is pretty much unusable. Now I tried a couple of things, like altering the sampling rate and transfer speed, and also improving the microphone amplifier circuits, but nothing helped to improve the audio quality. So me telling you that the transmitting range of around 50 meters is okay, the current consumption of 50 milliamps would guarantee a long runtime, and that designing a suitable housing for mounting the PCBs worked out smoothly, is not necessary anymore. Because for me, this Arduino walkie-talkie was a big failure. I guess sticking to dedicated wireless audio streaming ICs would have been the way to go, which I might try out in a future video. but nevertheless, feel free to pick up my design schematic and PCB of the project in order to maybe even fix an obvious and dumb mistake I made. I hope you enjoyed this video anyway and learned a bit about wireless audio transmission, even though my practical application did not work out as planned.